solve the differential equation x square multiplied to d square y by dx square plus x dy by dx plus y equated to 2 times sine of log x. Here we have differential equation numbered as equation 1 belongs to the class of Cauchy-Euler type of differential equation. We have coefficient of d square y by dx square is x square, coefficient of dy by dx is x, which are variable coefficients. And this is of the form x raised to n multiplied to d raised to n y by dx raised to n plus x raised to n minus 1 multiplied to d raised to n minus 1 y upon dx raised to n minus 1 plus etc. plus y, where a naught, a1, a2, etc. an are all equated to 1. In order to convert this differential equation to a differential equation with constant coefficients, we will make use of the transformation equation x equals e raised to t, also written as t equals log x. With this transformation equation, we can rewrite x dy by dx as capital D acting on y. X square d square y by dx square can be rewritten as capital D multiplied to d minus 1 acting on y, where capital D stands for differential operator with respect to independent variable t. Thus, we have the first term of equation 1 will be written as d into d minus 1 acting on y. The second term will be written as d acting on y. And the third term, which is independent of x, will have no modification. In the RHS part, instead of log x, we will write t. Thus, the RHS become 2 times sine t, which is a function on independent variable t. Differential equation numbered as equation 1 has x as the independent variable. On simplification, this differential equation becomes capital D square plus 1 acting on y equated to 2 times sine t. Let us call this differential equation as equation 2, and differential equation numbered as 2 has independent variable t, where capital D stands for d by dt. We will find out the solution of this differential equation because equation 2 is a differential equation with constant coefficients. We have auxiliary equation given by m square plus 1 equated to 0, and pi will be 1 by f of d acting on the RHS, which is 2 times sine t. Once we have found the solution of this differential equation 2, in order to write the general solution of equation 1, which is the Cauchy-Euler type of differential equation, we will again make use of the transformation equation x equals e raised to t or t equals log x. We have the auxiliary equation of equation 2 given by m square plus 1 equals 0 has imaginary roots m equals plus or minus iota. The real part of the root alpha equals 0 and the imaginary part of the root beta equals 1. Therefore, we have complementary function given by e raised to 0 t multiplied to c1 cos t plus c2 sin t, because equation 2 is a differential equation with independent variable t. The corresponding complementary function for differential equation 1 will be obtained by giving the transformation t equals log x. Thus, we have complementary function valid for differential equation 1, which is Cauchy-Euler type of differential equation, will be c1 cos log x plus c2 sin log x, where c1 and c2 are arbitrary constants. Now we will find out particular integral for differential equation numbered as equation 2, which is pi equals 1 by f of d acting on the RHS, which is 2 times sin t, where f of d equals d square plus 1. 2 can be taken outside the operation of this operator because it's a constant. Since we have sin t is a trigonometric function and coefficient of independent variable t equals 1, we can replace capital D square using negative of square of 1. When you replace capital D square by minus 1, the denominator becomes 0. Hence, we have to take the derivative of the denominator with respect to capital D. Simultaneously, we will multiply the numerator with independent variable t. Thus, we have pi equals 2t multiplied to 1 by 2d acting on sin t, where 2d is the derivative of d square plus 1 with respect to capital D. Since we have d is the differential operator with respect to independent variable t, we have 1 by d stands for integration with respect to independent variable t. Therefore, when 2 and 2 gets cancelled and sin t is integrated with respect to t, we obtain negative cos t. Hence, pi valid for differential equation numbered as equation 2 will be minus t cos t. In order to find out the corresponding pi for differential equation numbered as 1, which is Cauchy-Euler type of differential equation, we will again make use of the transformation equation t equals log x. Therefore, particular integral for differential equation numbered as 1 will be minus log x multiplied to cos of log x. In order to find out the general solution for equation 1, we will add up complementary function as well as particular integral, that is c1 cos log x plus c2 sin log x minus log x multiplied to cos of log x, which is the required solution of the given differential equation numbered as equation 1.